friends, a new era in military aviation is on the horizon. China has officially announced the first flight of its sixth-generation fighter jet, and this really changes the game. This aircraft isn't just a new toy for the military. It's a challenge to the whole world, especially the U.S. If such developments were once the prerogative of the states, now China is right on their heels. And this is not just a technology race. It's a fight for air supremacy, where every country wants to be first. The aircraft, which is practically invisible to radar, can autonomously analyze the combat situation and make decisions in real time. Sounds like something out of a sci-fi movie, but this is already a reality. And yes, with this rate of development, China has every chance to rewrite the rules of air combat. Now imagine the reaction of other countries. After all, every new fighter jet of this caliber is not just about defense. It's also a show of strength that can't be ignored. The Tatars, for example, have already begun to declare that they are ready to strengthen their positions. But how realistic is that? Today we are not just looking at technology, we are seeing a new chapter in world history. China clearly wants to be the author of it. To understand how China got to the sixth generation fighter, we need to go back a bit. In the 90s, their aviation was far from being in the leading roles. The level of technology lagged far behind the USA and Russia. But then came the J-10, the first fourth generation fighter. It was a breakthrough. A few years later, the J-20 was released, already the fifth generation. And China started competing with the world leaders. The J-20 has become a symbol of technological advancement. It has incorporated the best of global engineering, but China has added its own developments, such as improved stealth technology. If previously the country only copied other people's decisions, now it creates its own. And now the sixth generation is on the horizon. This is not just a new aircraft, but a concept where the fighter becomes part of an entire system. China is no longer just catching up, it's experimenting and looking for new ways. All this shows how, in two decades, the country was able to transform from a follower into a leader. And their speed of development is impressive. In just 20 years, they've covered a distance that took other countries several decades. So, what makes the new Chinese sixth generation fighter so special? First of all, it's stealth. If the J-20 was almost invisible to radar, the new aircraft will be completely hidden from enemy eyes. It's considered to be one of the most invisible aircraft ever created. Secondly, there's artificial intelligence. That's a huge step forward. The new fighter can independently analyze the situation. For example, identify threats, select targets, and even make decisions without the pilot's involvement. All of this reduces reaction time in combat and increases effectiveness. Besides that, there are rumors about a three-engine configuration. What's it for? First of all, it provides more power, allowing for supersonic speeds and better maneuverability. Secondly, it makes the plane more agile in tough conditions. And finally, a new level of electronics. The fighter can interact with drones, ground systems, and satellites. This isn't just a plane, it's a command center that monitors the entire air situation. You could say this isn't just a step forward, but a quantum leap in military aviation. The Nanman project is the key to China's air strategy. Its goal is to create a fully integrated ecosystem for conducting combat operations. Imagine a fighter jet that doesn't operate alone, but works alongside drones, satellites, and ground systems. This completely changes the approach to air combat. The new fighter will be able to coordinate the actions of dozens of drones that can conduct reconnaissance, attack, or even distract the enemy's attention. It's like a game of chess, where every move is planned in advance. In addition, the Nanman project involves the use of the most advanced technologies, such as artificial intelligence and quantum communication systems. But what does this give China? First and foremost, it's a strategic advantage. Such a system allows for quicker responses to threats and minimizes risks. Secondly, it's a demonstration of power. China is showing that it's not just catching up to the US, but it can also offer completely new approaches to conducting military operations. Last week, an event happened in China that blew up social media. The country unveiled two new stealth fighters at once. And it wasn't an official presentation. Both aircraft were spotted conducting test flights over densely populated areas, sparking a flurry of speculation. But here's what's interesting. Experts are still arguing whether these tests were random. Or is this part of a large-scale information campaign by China? After all, in our time, when everyone who has a smartphone becomes an eyewitness to such events, hiding something is becoming almost impossible. One of the aircraft, analysts say, is an upgraded J-20 with additional improvements such as an improved radar and more powerful engines. The second, completely new device, the development of which is kept strictly secret. This fighter looks like a result of further evolution. Stealth technologies. All these maneuvers make it clear that China is not just experimenting, but is actively promoting its developments. And if such aircraft are already visible on test flights, then one can only guess. What else is hidden in the closed hangars? But that's not all. China is actively testing stealth drones that could change the way we think about air operations. One of these drones was spotted recently. Its shape and size clearly suggest that it's not just a reconnaissance aircraft, and a full-fledged weapon for future battles. The drone is said to be able to accompany sixth-generation fighters into combat, acting as a wingman. It will analyze the situation, draw radar attention, and even strike targets. This strategy makes combat operations more flexible and effective. Interestingly, the drone is designed with a tailless configuration, which means it doesn't have the usual tail fins. This enhances its stealth against radars and also improves its aerodynamic performance. Basically, this is another step into the future where drones play a key role. But why is this important? Drones of this type help save resources and reduce risks for pilots. Plus, they're easier to produce in large quantities. China seems to be betting on mass automation in military aviation, which gives the country a clear advantage in future conflicts. To understand how China arrived at its new fighter jet, it's worth taking a look at their previous projects. These include the FC-31 and J-35. The first flight of the FC-31 took place back in 2012, and at that time, it became a real sensation. It was the first Chinese fighter jet that truly competed with Western counterparts. However, the project faced difficulties. The FC-31 remained in the prototype stage for a long time, and only recently have rumors emerged about its possible entry into service. However, some believe that it serves more as a test platform for rolling out new technologies. The J-35 is an evolution of the idea behind the FC-31, but with a focus on adaptation for aircraft carriers. This means that China wants to create a powerful aircraft carrier group that can project power anywhere in the world. Interestingly, both of these projects could serve as the foundation for developing new fighter jets. China is actively experimenting, and each new aircraft is a step toward creating the perfect machine for aerial combat. Essentially, the FC-31 and J-35 are a bridge between the past and the future of Chinese aviation. Now let's compare Chinese and American aviation technologies. At first glance, it might seem like the US is way ahead. After all, their sixth-generation fighter program started back in 2014, and they already have several prototypes. But here's the thing. China is developing faster. If the US is betting on quality and long-term reliability, then China is ready to experiment and implement new technologies. Right now, for example, Chinese engineers are actively working on integrating artificial intelligence, while the Americans are focused on stealth and supersonic speed. In addition, China is actively developing drones that will be able to work in tandem with fighter jets. In this area, the country is clearly outpacing the US. On the other hand, the Americans have enormous experience and resources. Their aircraft, such as the F-22 and F-35, have already proven their effectiveness. Chinese fighters have yet to be tested in real combat. Yet, despite all the differences, both countries are moving towards the same goal of creating air superiority. And it is too early to say who will come out on top. But one thing is clear, this competition will be decisive for the future of global aviation. The Chinese sixth-generation fighter project, known as the White Emperor, has already become a legend in the aviation industry. Although many details of this project are kept secret, there is information that makes you think about the scale of China's ambitions. The White Emperor is a fifth-generation fighter. The Emperor is not just a fighter jet. It's a machine capable of flying at supersonic speeds and even going beyond the atmosphere. Imagine a plane that can ascend to low Earth orbit to carry out reconnaissance or combat missions. This is no longer science fiction, but a real prospect. One of the key features of this machine will be a fully integrated artificial intelligence. This AI will be able not only to analyze the situation on the battlefield, but also to predict the enemy's actions. It will adapt to rapidly changing conditions and make decisions without pilot involvement. And one more important point, the White Emperor will be equipped with the most advanced weaponry, including hypersonic missiles. This is a weapon that's hard to detect and even harder to intercept. China is clearly betting on becoming a leader in military technology. And the White Emperor could be the key to that leadership. This project is a challenge to the whole world, showcasing not only China's ambitions, but also raising the bar for other countries. In addition to combat fighters, China is making significant strides in developing unmanned cargo planes. One of these projects recently passed successful tests. It was developed by Sichuan Tianjin Technology, and it's designed to deliver cargo to hard-to-reach areas. This drone looks like a mix between a drone and a regular cargo plane. Its main feature is the ability to carry up to 20 tons of cargo over a distance of more than 1,000 kilometers. This allows it to be used in areas where there is no developed infrastructure or where conducting humanitarian operations requires quick and efficient delivery. But there's also a military aspect. Such a drone can be used to supply troops in hard-to-reach areas, delivering equipment, or even transporting weapons. This makes it a versatile tool that can be used in both peacetime and wartime. In addition, the cargo plane is equipped with an advanced navigation system that allows it to fly around turbulence zones and avoid collisions with other objects. This makes it even more reliable. This project shows that China is looking not just at the battlefield, but also at logistics, which is a crucial part of any modern military campaign. As we wrap up our discussion of Chinese fighter jets, let's consider how these technologies might impact the future. After all, the emergence of the sixth generation of combat aircraft is not just a new round of aviation development. It's an opportunity for countries to shift the balance of power on the global stage. The technological data that China is gathering and developing is becoming a tool for global influence. Stealth technology, AI, hypersonic weapons, drones, these are all game changers. But with these new capabilities come, and new threats. For example, autonomous systems like combat drones can be used not just on the battlefield, but also for spying or cyber attacks. In a world where technology is advancing so quickly, it's important to understand how to protect ourselves from its misuse. China is making huge strides forward, but it raises questions about how other countries will respond to such an arms race. After all, every new development demands a response. And here it's important not just to catch up, but to look for new ways to develop. So, let's summarize. China isn't just developing new fighter jets, it's changing the game in global aviation. The sixth generation of combat aircraft, drones, integration, and hypersonic weapons. All of this puts China in the spotlight, comparing them to the US and other countries. We see that China isn't just catching up, it's also offering its unique solutions. This is no longer just about copying technologies. It's about rethinking and adapting them to their own needs. What happens next? Can China become a leader in this field? And how will this affect the global balance of power? For now, we don't have answers to these questions. But one thing is clear. We live in an era where technology is changing everything, including aviation. Thanks for watching this video. Leave a comment about what you think the future of aviation looks like and who you believe will be the leader in this race. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss new episodes. See you later.